Hi, Rosemarie. Thank you for joining us today. How are you?
Wonderful to see you, Stephanie.
And wonderful to see you. Can you tell us a little bit about your role and about Prairie Naturals?
Well, by profession, I'm a pharmacist, but I'm a holistic pharmacist. I've been involved with Prairie and natural products for up to 50 years now. And for the last 30 years, I've been supporting Prairie as it's developed its full line of natural health products, including personal body care, especially hair care products.
Fantastic. And can you tell us a little bit about the story of Prairie Naturals itself?
Yeah. Prairie Naturals was started by Robert Pierce, and Robert had a vision of having very clean hair care. That was his first line of product. And he had had the idea of removing perfumes, because perfumes in the early 90s were still in even regular health food hair care products. Mm-hmm. And of course, we had sulfates and all of these more mainstream type ingredients in hair care. But he knew that you could make it cleaner. So he sent his formulator to research it, who said it couldn't be done. And he said, yes, it can be. We were the first to bring no sulfate products on the Canadian market in the early 90s. And we've gone through three generations of, we first removed perfumes and even most of the essences and put in essential oils that actually support hair. And our products are condition specific. So they have very different blends of herbs and essential oils in them. And then we started looking at the preservatives and have gone through generations of finding really very clean preservatives. We've moved into organic ingredients, bringing in as many organic ingredients. So our aim is to have a very clean product that is condition specific for a person's hair and skin type, as well as something that they can trust is clean and eco-friendly. Eco-friendly, supporting the environment. And that's really important, especially mm-hmm. since all of this is going into our water system, right? Anything we put on our body is ending up in the water system.
Mm. And so why else do we, you know, have concern about the ingredients in our personal care products? Why should we be concerned about that other than, you know, into the water, of course, like you mentioned?
Well, the chemicals that were developed for as surfactants, or you know, the detergent, the mm-hmm. the foaming agents, the emollients, all of these were based on the byproducts of the petroleum industry.
Mm.
So, because you need a long chain fatty acids to work with cleansing, they went to the very cheap byproducts of petroleum. Unfortunately, most of these have the same chemical makeup as our estrogen. So they become what we call estrogen mimickers. That's one of the big problems, is that they actually, and they're quite strong. So as we put them on our skin, we get exposed to these chemicals, which get taken in. Our skin is the largest organ. So whether it's the hair in the scalp or on the skin, what we wanted to do was get as many as possible. First of all, use no petroleum products, no petroleum base. Mostly we can use coconut oil as a fat base. So that's something that's really valuable. And then to remove the type of chemicals that we know can potentially cause cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes it's because they're in combination with each other, and sometimes they're just not the most ecological friendly, something that matches the body and that the body can work with. For example, glycerin. Glycerin is an emollient, and it helps to absorb these into the hair and the hair follicle, these nutrient-based herbal blends that we have. But in regular cosmetics and hair care products, you'll find them using the very cheap product called propylene glycol, a byproduct of the petroleum industry, and it's an estrogen mimicker. This is important both for females and males because we both have estrogen receptors. No male wants to have too much estrogen, and females do not want to have these synthetic estrogens either in their body. So propylene glycol is a big one. You know, having products that are non-GMO. Now, one might think, why would shampoos be GMO? Well, if you're putting herbal extracts and essential oils, things can get in there. So you have to check for that. You want it to be gluten-free, of course, for those people that are very sensitive. We also don't want to test it on animals, to be cruelty-free. And not to have very strong preservatives. Because preservatives tend to, you need a broad spectrum preservative, but if it's a harsh one, it will affect the environment as well.
Well, it's very fascinating. So tell us a little bit about the spray conditioner, the Mountain Mist conditioner.
Just before I do that, I remembered I wanted to let you know that in our Prairie Natural literature, we have this, I don't know if I can show it to you, but it is a questionnaire that sits in our literature called the CEU, the Cosmetic Quotient. Now, this lets a person see how many products they're using that's being applied to their hair, skin, body care products. And then to take a look at them to make sure they don't contain any of these ingredients that I just talked about, as well as a list of a larger group. And we talk about this so that a person can become aware they might be very healthy shopping for good organic food, using good quality supplements like Prairie Naturals. But often they don't think about their bubble bath or their toothpaste or their hair care products. And so that's why what we're trying to do is bring in awareness to look at your hair care products, look at what you might be putting in your body and reading labels. So I wanted to get in that this is something that we've been passionate about, this CEU, this little questionnaire, to help bring awareness. And it isn't just for Prairie products. It's so that all body care could be looked at.
That's reading fantastic. Labels,
so important.
It is very, very much so.
So you asked me about Mountain Mist.
I did, yes.
So Mountain Mist is one of Prairie's, and I'm actually going to show it to you because I use it. So here it is.
Fabulous.
Mountain Mist is one of Prairie's styling aids. It's in the conditioner line, but it's used as a leave-in conditioner. Really helps with to manage hair, to create smoothness, remove tangles. You could use it on somebody who's quite young if they have a volume of hair, where you've really got knots in it or you need to take out the tangles. Also creates volume so that the hair becomes more manageable, less frizzy and easier to style. So it's actually beautifully scented. And what it contains are essential oils, especially of lavender and lemon and chamomile. And these three help to create the absolutely beautiful fragrance. And that fragrance won't last long because it's natural. If you have and spray something on your hair and after an hour or two move your head and you can smell it, that means it's got synthetic chemicals. And of course, perfumes have up to 400 different ingredients. A lot of them are very detrimental. And so one can kind of tell that by how long the fragrance lingers. So this is a very beautiful light scent, and it won't last more than an hour or so. So it won't interfere with other scents you might be wearing, but naturally just blends in. It's quite lovely on the hair. And you can use it on any hair type.
Mm-hmm. And on small children?
Yes, if they have a volume of hair, if they have the very finest baby hair, you still can use it, but you just would use a lot less. It's very safe and mild, so it would not irritate scalp. Although, given that it has a herbal blend, and a lot of these herbs are also organic, but like aloe vera and chamomile and horsetail, it would be good always with a young child to do a taste, not taste test, but a little skin test. I usually use the inside of the arm and just to put a little there and make sure that no redness happens.
That's a great idea.
Yeah. Just as a pharmacist, that's something that with everything, if you want to, before you put it in your mouth, try it on your skin. Right? Mm-hmm. It is a supplement, but you can do that with product with very young children. I highly recommend that.
So it's natural. There are natural essential oils in there, aloe vera herbal blend. Yeah. So what makes it so effective from other conditioners that might be out there on the market?
Well, I think first of all, it's the way that we've blended the amino acids. They're silk amino acids, so they come out of the separated out of silk, and these really are great emollients and supportive for the function of hair. So there's the silk aminos, there's a glycerin coconut oil emollient, and some vitamin B5. So those three are the sort of the starting foundation. And then the aqueous herbs are added along with the essential oils and some really high quality organic fatty acids that come from pomegranate seed and cranberry seed. Mm-hmm. So when you combine these emollient oils with the supportive herbs and essential oils, that makes quite a unique blend that is not heavy on the hair. It's done in such a way that it doesn't weigh down the hair. Mm. You can easily spritz and spray it and not feel sticky and have a wonderful scent. Often the way I've demonstrated this to people is just to spray it in the air and let them move into it. You can feel the wonderful lightness and beautiful scent to it.
Sounds fantastic.
Yeah, it's actually been a product that I've loved for a long time. Mm-hmm. And so glad. And not many companies actually offer a spray and conditioner that's clean. That probably is the most uniqueness, is to have a clean product with a preservative system that is ecologically friendly, that's accepted to be even used in a certified organic product. Mm-hmm. So this preservative system is one of our greatest additions to the rebranding of our line. And I'm so pleased. It works very well. It's fragrance-free. It's great for people that have sensitivities as well.
Sounds fantastic. I mean, very safe preservative system. Like you were saying, lots of organic ingredients, eco-certified. Fantastic. I can't wait to try this. Is there anything else you'd like to really tell our audience or that you'd like them to know about Prairie Naturals or the Mountain Mist Conditioner?
Well, I guess I would just like to end by saying that I've been using these products in their evolutions over the last almost 30 years now. And I'm turning 71 this year.
And I can't believe that.
This hair has had a lot of Prairie products on it. And Mountain Mist is part of my routine. My hair, believe it or not, is quite curly and quite frizzy. It's fine. It's like straw almost. But because I am able to use these fantastic products, first of all, for cleansing and then for styling, I find that my hair is quite manageable. Matter of fact, some of our representatives have said, Rosemarie, you should show a before and after picture and just how wonderful a product, such a simple product, can support the shine and manageability of hair.
Sounds fabulous. I have to try this.
I think you'd love it. You have very beautiful hair, and I'm not sure how much effort it takes you to get it to there, but you'll find that Mountain Mist will make it less effort.
Excellent. Anything for, yes, absolutely. Less effort is fantastic for me. It takes a lot. I have that frizzy kind of hair as well. So where can we find Prairie Natural products?
Prairie Naturals is sold across Canada in health food stores and in health food sections of the larger stores. Anybody that has a body care section usually will have Prairie Naturals, and if not, they can very quickly get it for you.
Excellent. And how can people contact Prairie Naturals?
Well, the website is a place to go for more information, and that's Prairie Naturals with an S at the end, .ca. And there's a place there that you can ask questions, and you can also go into the products and take a look at the wonderful hair care line that Prairie Naturals has, with all of its styling aids as well. We've got them all now back and with our new labels, and really pleased.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Rosemarie. It was so informative and such a pleasure speaking with you today.
Thank you, Stephanie.